In my mind, I'm gone to Carolina. Can't you see the sunshine? Can't you just feel the moonshine? Ain't it just like a friend of mine to hit me from behind? Yes, I'm gone to Carolina in my mind. Karen, she's a silver sun. You best walk her away and watch it shining. Watch her watch the morning come. A silver tear appearing now. I'm crying, ain't I? No doubt in no one's mind that love's the finest thing around.
Ella's favorite memory is running on the beach with Grammy this year. My favorite memory with Grammy is when she came to see Ella, her first great-grandchild, at the hospital.
My favorite memory of Grammy is coming to the beach every year and going to eat at Hyman's and hang out on the beach.
I'm gone to Carolina. Can't you see the sunshine? Can't you just feel the moonshine?
Mom, what I just was so blessed is your time with everybody and these family vacations. I remember family vacations from when we were super little, and they just evolved, and it's gone to my children, my grandchildren, and we're just so thankful for the love and the gifts that you have given us and feel so blessed. Thank you.
Signs, it might be omens, say I'm going.
And kind of to reiterate on that with the family vacations, it's been great to be all together, but not to break out in song. But it's been enjoyable to watch Grammy and Papa experience with us, with Zachary and Courtney, to experience the ocean as well as Ella now. It's been a great experience.
My favorite memory of Grammy is our Grammy days. Back when I was little and going to physical therapy, those were always so much fun, and just coming to the beach and being able to enjoy family. I think that she and Papa have a lot to do with that. So thank you.
In my mind, I'm gone to Carolina. Can't you see the sunshine? Can't you just feel the moonshine? Ain't it just like a friend of mine to hit me from behind? Yes, I'm gone to Carolina.
My favorite Grammy memory is when I was driving back to Tennessee from the Quad Cities, and I kind of made a split second decision to stop and visit Grammy. And I knocked on the door, she had no idea I was coming, and she opens it, she goes, "Bryce, is it you?"
Hello?
Bryce?
I wonder if you were accepting a visitor.
Is it you?
It's Bryce, hi.
Bryce?
Hi.
Just talked to Melissa.
Yes.
20 minutes ago.
And just like sitting there so happy, and she welcomed me in for the night, you know, put me in a room. She had cookies freshly baked and stuff. And I learned after the trip that is not something people normally do at Grammys, surprise her like that. But I didn't know that because of how she welcomed me and was just so excited to have me there and see me. And we talked for hours that night, just sitting up and talking. And it wasn't until I told Audrey about it that I found out that, hey, next time maybe give her a warning. So I thought that was really special that she was so sweet, even though that's something that she's not necessarily accustomed to.
Oh, so many memories. But I just, I love the way that Grammy is always so supportive of all of her children, grandchildren, now great-grandchildren. I just remember every single spring recital she was there supporting me and just interested and asking me questions, just pointing out details about the dance. And I just feel like she does that with each and every one of us. And just really shows, you know, her heart, you know, for her grandchildren and her children and everybody really. And I just love that even when we're not all together, you know, even though her heart is for us to all be together, she loves it when we're all together, but she really makes the most of times when it's just, you know, individual, you know, like when it was just Bryce that one time out of the blue, or if it's a planned trip with just one person or two people or a big get together like this. Like, she's just so thankful and just loves everybody so much, and I just adore that about her. And I adore that about you, Grammy, and I love that you're continuing on these traditions of getting together at Folly Beach, and you never like make anybody feel bad if they can't make it. You're just thankful that, you know, for the people who can be here, and you love the people that can't be here still. But I just love that you've continued on this tradition, and it's a legacy that I think you've instilled in your children, and that it's been instilled in us, and it's gonna be passed on through the generations. And I really appreciate that you and Papa have done that. When I think of Grammy, I see someone that I've always looked up to and that I truly admire. Grammy, you just have an incredible heart and such a contagious joy that I really just love. I'm just so thankful for all of your support and I just feel like we've always had a really great connection, and I'm really thankful for you and just how you've loved me and set such a great example. And I can truly say that someday I hope to become even a portion of the woman you are, because you are truly incredible. So many great things, true things being said about you, Mom. One of my favorite memories of you is when I just have always felt welcome, and that's such a good thing. These are happy tears. And I'll never forget when you almost cracked your tooth when when you found out or heard about our engagement. You're always so enthusiastic, and that night after the engagement, I went into my room where I was sleeping, and you had laid out a daisy, and you had written, "He loves me, he loves me not," and you were very careful to make sure it landed on "He loves me," and that's really, I appreciate that, and I just love that. I thought to myself at that moment, like, I want to be a mother-in-law like her someday. And so thank you for all the many, many memories, your great smile and your enthusiasm, your positivity, all those things I admire so much, and I love you.
I hope you're enjoying the scenery. I know that it's pretty up there.
Mom, there are so many qualities that I admire about you and that you've instilled in me. And one that I just truly, firmly believe is that you have not just lived, you have lived well. And you're always optimistic, excited, bubbly about something coming up. And it's just taught me to really learn to anticipate things with great excitement. And one thing I've learned is that sometimes the anticipation of an exciting event, it can almost be as great as the event itself. And just some quick examples, you know, the very last episode of MASH, you know, I mean, you did a party, you know, you had the camouflage tablecloth and we ate MASH food and just, you know, we ate out of these, you know, tin pans, and, you know, that's just one example, but I think it's very relevant to our time here at Folly now. You know, just your excitement every time we've come to Folly from the very first time, you know, you put the blocks up Folly Beach, here we come. You know, you start wearing your Folly shirt and packing your bag, and in the car on the way here, singing the silly songs, and I think that's likely part of the reason why Papa, Dad just really felt that being in the car on the way to Folly Beach was such a joy-filled time for him, was because his wife, you Mom, were just, you really knew how to just be excited about events coming up. And this time now, I remember 2 years ago, the last time that our family was at Folly Beach, you were excited and talking about your dream for your 80th birthday, and just how that's what you would want more than anything else. And it just brings me such joy that here we are, Mom, on your birthday, 80th birthday, celebrating with you, you know, a woman who we've learned so much from and admired in so many ways. So, love you, Mom.
Hey, Grammy, we have so many incredible memories with you, but one recent one that came to mind was when you read us The Best Nest, all together snuggled up on your couch. That brought back a lot of great memories for me, and it was also fun for Sydney to be included. And we're excited for Kaden to be included with that tradition soon. We love you so much.
Grammy, one of my favorite memories at Folly a few weeks ago was getting to spend time with you and sitting with you and just hearing your past stories from Folly and hearing some of your fondest memories, and just really brings me a lot of joy to hear just all those fun times that you had and that you're still having.
Hi, Grammy. One of my favorite memories with you, I think, would be when you would take us all out onto the beach and do the moonwalk. That was a lot of fun, and I'll never forget that. Even just when you and Papa would visit here, we'd do it for fun out in the yard. And that was just a good time, and I'll always cherish those memories.
You fill up my senses, come fill me again.
My favorite memory of Grammy is every year when we go shopping to West County or wherever we go and spend a whole day out there and then get sushi and now wine and spend hours there talking about everything and nothing and her slathering wasabi on sushi rolls like butter.
All right, so my favorite memories are happened here at Folly. Going back from Dad out tubing early in the morning, watching him go up and down on the waves, telling ghost stories to all the nieces and nephews, and just spending some fabulous trips on Folly. Dad always said that the drive to Folly was one of his favorite parts of the trip, and I'd have to agree with that, as this year for Mom's birthday, we got to travel with my full family on Father's Day Sunday, so that made it extra special. I think just all the memories of Folly are just wonderful experiences for everybody.
Always makes me high.
And I think it's hard to pick one memory. I think over the years, in your mind and your heart, it becomes a collage of memories. We were speaking yesterday and remembering a special pizza place that Margie Schooler would take us all to, and we would have white pizza and house wine. And my first trip there, didn't realize how potent the house wine was until it was time to leave and had to hold Grammy's arm as we crossed the street. So that was fun. I think when you think of words for Folly, I was thinking about this, and it's a place where you find kind of a soothing for your soul and connectedness in the family, and remember what the peace is to just get away and relax a little bit and let the ocean waves and the sunrise and sunsets regenerate yourself. So I think those are all things for me that make this such a special place.
My favorite memory of Grammy would have to be like just all the support she's given me over the years, especially at band events. Like, never miss a single one, especially like those Wednesday night practices. Parents usually show up like maybe 8:30 to 9. She was there bright and early, 6 p.m. And anytime I turned around, she was always the first parent I saw out there. So that was always a special thing for me.
For me, I think my favorite memory of Grammy is
Lately I've been going out to her house once a week to help her around the house and kind of just visit with her. I usually get there about 9 and don't do anything around the house until about 9:45 because we're chatting over coffee and gossiping and just doing kind of like a weekly check-in and talking about really anything at all. So I think that's something that I look forward to every week and really enjoy doing.
One of my top favorite memories of Folly Beach was in May of 2008, and we were in Dayton, Iowa with baby Marilyn, and we called Gogo and Papa saying, "We know you're going to the beach, just the two of you, but can we join you?" So we drove to Minneapolis with baby Marilyn, although she's probably 10 months old, flew down to Charleston, got in really late at night, and spent the week with them here on the beach in their little one-bedroom condo. And it was so fun. It was fun to see Adam take his first child out to the beaches that he grew up going to. And then with all the boys around 2 or 3 months old, we got to bring them all to the beach. And then now with baby Desmond, not even 2 weeks old, has made his beach debut. So I'm just thankful for the gift of this passing on to family members and kids and grandkids, and just very, very special.
My memory is, I think, 2017, when we had the beach house with like the little balcony on top on the roof. And I always wanted to hang out with my older cousins because I didn't have any younger cousins. They were all my brothers. So I wanted to hang out with my older cousins. So I'd go up there and they'd play games, they'd talk, they'd look up stuff on their phones. And every once in a while, one of them would ask if I could go down and get them a drink. And then a couple more would ask, "Could you give me a drink? Give me this, give me that." So I'd go down and I'd get them stuff. But I didn't mind it because every time I went down, I'd get another cookie. So I just went down and basically got them stuff and I got them cookies. So.
Yeah. One of my memories was, I think the last time we were here, I was out bobbing with my dad and Uncle Eric, and I could just feel the presence of Papa with us. I liked bobbing the waves and making sand castles. I really liked playing bocce ball in the sand, and also I liked the cupcakes at
Lewis really likes playing bocce ball, and this year he was bobbing in the waves and boogie boarding. So I think he likes being out in the water. And the tide pool, the air tube, the inner tube.
Yes, those are fun.
Yeah.
And I'd say my memories go way, way back. And there are more memories than I could even begin to recount, just so many wonderful times here. But I remember being I would say that my memories go way back to when I was maybe even Lewis's age. Just so much fun being down here as a family, the older siblings, and I had this already before. Okay, I'll be tough. So, I loved the Skipper's house, just the old house, the memories there. I have salt water in my eye. The memories there of just an old little beach house, no air conditioning, laying in bed and having the wind blow in from the open window, and the curtains blowing over my face, and just, I think, I'll keep it short now, but just what the gift is for me is that Folly Beach is not so much of a place where we go, but you've made it a place in our hearts. Sorry. But I think what's so great is that Folly Beach has been a place for us all to go and to be together and to strengthen our relationships as a family and to make memories but so much of it is that it's not just a place where we can go, but Gogo and Papa both helped put a place in our hearts where we can be together and celebrate family and live those memories. And this place is just so special to us because it connects to that place in our hearts where we can be together as a family. So I think I'm most thankful for that. And you know, Mom, there's so much emotion around Papa, just with him not here, but it's you too, and you just do so much to make this a special place and to care for our family. And you know, I think of Papa saying, if there's any place he could be in a car on the way to Folly Beach. And so much of that, Mom, is because of you and just being together as a family. You've helped make this place a wonderful home away from home and make wonderful memories. And so it's a joy to be here and to celebrate it with you for this 80th birthday, knowing that we've been coming here for over half your life now and making many, many wonderful memories. So I love the chances I get to spend with my kids right now and all the nieces and nephews and a whole new generation of your great-grandchildren. So thank you very much. And we love you, and we will always hold this place in our hearts as we celebrate the gift and the blessings that God has given to us here in this place.
Here's to the ones that we got. Cheers to the wish you were here, but you're not. Cause the drinks bring back all the memories of everything we've been through. Toast to the ones that today. Toast to the ones that we lost on the way. Cause the drinks bring back all the memories, and the memories, bring back your. There's a time that I remember when I did not know no pain, when I believed in forever and everything would stay the same. Now my heart feels like December when somebody say your name. Cause I can't reach out to call you, but I know I will one day. Everybody hurts sometimes, everybody hurts someday, hey, hey. But everything gon' be alright, gon' raise a glass and say, hey. Here's to the ones that we got. Cheers to the wish you were here, but you're not. Cause the dreams bring back all the memories of everything we've been through. Toast to the ones here today. Toast to the ones that we lost on the way. Cause the drinks bring back all the memories, and the memories, bring back your. Memories, bring back your. There's a time that I remember when I never felt so lost, and I felt all of the hatred was too powerful to stop. Now my heart feels like an ember, and it's lighting up the dark. I'll carry these torches for ya, and you know I'll never drop. Yeah. Everybody hurts sometimes, everybody hurts someday, yeah, yeah. But everything gon' be alright, gon' raise a glass and say, hey. Here's to the ones that we got. Cheers to the wish you were here, but you're not. Cause the drinks bring back all the memories of everything we've been through. Toast to the ones here today. Toast to the ones that we lost on the way. Cause the drinks bring back all the memories, and the memories bring back, memories bring.